Oh, it's good.
Hello, I'm Tyson Walker, and I'm a freshman.
I'm Lillian McAvoy, I'm a freshman.
I'm Mylan Kaufman, I'm a senior.
I'm a Sean Keir, I'm a senior, we're from Omaha Central. And this is our group piece titled, Kids These Days.
Kids these days, you say we're the future? That's an understatement.
Because every time we start a movement, you try to kill the message.
If the message we convey doesn't fit your foot, you stomp on us.
So then we are beneath you.
But we were not put on this earth to be your stepping stool.
I mean, we're not wrong. It's just our mouths are inferior.
Due to a concept created by man.
Time. Time does not determine intelligence.
17 hearts stop beating on Valentine's Day.
But we have to sit with our mouths sealed. Sealed because belittlement is the only thing we should feel.
Kids these days.
Always on their phones.
Prefer to be alone.
Prefer to ignore the world around them.
And what a lie!
What a semi-truthful lie.
Our generation.
Generating more work for the rest of us.
Lazy.
Dyed hair.
And we're all dying in school shootings.
Cyberbullying and instant messaging.
Our troubles boomers just can't understand.
Texts fly faster than nukes explode.
And our minds are radioactive.
And we need to be active and prove older
kids these days
wrong.
You were all kids back in the day.
Yes, we are kids, but we are people.
Just younger people.
People demanding to be heard in an ocean of tweets and all too instant messaging.
And time flies faster than our hands on iPhone screens.
But we are still the young.
The beautiful.
And the angry.
And they say, if you're so angry, why don't you do something about it?
We're here to try and do something about it.
Kendrick Lamar once said,
I am the wisdom of the fallen, I am the youth.
We may not have lived as long as you.
We may not have experienced the same things you have. But we, the youth, have seen bullets mold into the bodies of our peers. We have seen tribes ambush and massacre our own. Yes, some have lived for many moons, but we are not blind to the darkness that blankets this earth. We are standing on our last leg. When we speak out, it's not to undermine you. Instead, we raise our voices to the very people that should stand for us, but they don't. So we have to stand for ourselves. We should be graded on our ability to take tests, not our ability to hide underneath desks.
First,
we must stand together against the rising tide of doubt. We must form a protective shield around those brave enough to speak out. We must be brave enough to speak out.
Protest.
Volunteer.
March.
Vote.
Petition your legislators.
From the mouths of dying babes,
we will echo your cry.
Kids these days.
If you knock one of us down,
30 more will rise. Thank you.